Myself Nitish, quantitative surveying and contract management. This is a module number 3, fourth part of video. We'll continue the part 3 video from here. That is, we are continuing the part 3 video in part 4. This is a part 4 video. Please concentrate on the lecturing here. We discussed in the part 3 video, that is RB portion of the wall 0.9 and 0.1 total length. That is RB wall is RB wall thickness is, you can see here the thickness, total thickness of RB wall, that is this wall thickness, you can see it here. That is 10. That is 3.9 into the total height is, that RB wall, sorry. Point 0.1 and the total height is 1.35. That height you can see it here, 1.2 plus 15, so 1.35. The RB is 10 centimeter thickness, you can see here RB standing wall, so 10 centimeter into plus 1.35, that 1.35 came from 1.2 plus 0.15, so that is whatever your total height. Now we'll go for another particular. That particular is of what? RCC 1:2:4 roof slab cover. So that roof slab cover, so including assuming cover also, so that what is the RCC slab length? So you can see this RCC slab length is, the total length of the RCC slab is 3.70, that is 3.70 plus 10 centimeter bearing. 10 centimeter bearing you can see here on either side. 10 centimeter bearing on either side. So 10 centimeter bearing here, it will be there either side. You cannot see in the section sometimes. So it is either side 10 centimeter bearing. So total length become 3.70 inner to inner length plus 10 centimeter either side. So that will be 3.7 plus 10 either side. So that is equal to 3.90. That's all. Simple. Okay. And now another one is 1.10. How 1.10 is nothing but the breadth, that is 9.9 is the total, that is 0.9 inner to inner wall open, the open is 0.9, the breadth of the opening is 0.9 total open. So here, that is, this is 20 total length of the open. So breadth, if you take, it will be, it look like this. If, for example, if I do like this, the figure, if I do like this, it will look like this here, manhole or septic tank look like this. So that, this open is nothing but this open, you cannot, this open is nothing but this much. Okay, this open is nothing but total breadth. So that breadth is, I'll just erase it, sorry. That breadth is 0.9. That is, you can see it in the top plan, isn't it? The point here you can see, plus 10 centimeter bearing, inside bearing, that is 0.9 plus 0.9 both the side, that is 1.10. And thickness of the slab, you can see it here, the thickness of the slab is 7.5 centimeter divided by 100. If you do, so 0.075, you will get the total volume of the RCC slab is 3.9 into 0.10 into 0.7075. The total is equal to 0.322 cubic meter. Okay, that is your total total four items which I wanted to be discussed with you. So total it is earthwork excavation, hard soil and foundation and base width CC 1:3:6, first class brick masonry in CM 1:4, and long, this is the long wall as well as short wall, and RCC slab. We'll go to another problem, very simple. Here, the important concept is prepare a detailed estimation. Here, important concept. One more concept is here. Prepare a detailed estimation of septic tank shown in the figure 7.3 and detail of items which is given below. Which is given below. 1 minute. Here, earthwork excavation in a hard soil, one thing. Second thing is foundation. Third one, first class brick masonry. And RCC slab 1:2:4, slab cover, plastering with a cement mortar 1:4. Now, we'll just clarify it. Prepare a detailed estimation of septic tank shown in the figure. Here we are, they have given the septic tank with a soak with details. So five items are there. Just see the figure here. Very important figure. Here, septic tank which is made up of a RCC slab with a footing. The first, before the last problem which we discussed, it is only of septic tank, but here including soak pits are given. The soak pit you can see here, brick bats are here inside, so that filtering, this is filters where I already discussed what is the manhole, what is septic tank and what is the duty of septic tank and what is the function of septic tank. So that in from the septic tank, the wastewater is collected. Here all the sludge, the organic material will be retained in the bottom of the tank and only the clear water will go. That is also some organic matter. So that has to be the floating organic matter which is not able to settle by its own gravity. Kind of particle will be traveled through these brick bats. And here see, the walls are with the open joints are there here. This vaults, open joints are provided, total height is 4 meters. From this water is falling through this brick bats and then it will be traveled to the ground. That's all. That is the function of the soak pit. The septic tank, the function is different and soak pit function is different. In the septic tank, what is the difference between septic tank? Septic tank here it is, septic tank and soak pit. This is entire, it is called soak pit. The difference between the septic tank is nothing but it is collection of the or your sewage which is coming from the latrine and collection, and it if certain time will be given, that is called detention period, that has to be given, and then the remaining here organic matter will be settled off, that is your sludge is called settled off and solids. Then it will be, the water will be traveled to the soak pit. Why it is, in soak pit it will be traveled to ground. So ground water should not be polluted. So ground water should not be contaminated with the sewage. So that purpose it is going to filter with the soak pit. This soak pit is nothing but construction material is brick pads, and here some open joints will be there. So that here RCC slab is provided so that water will be traveling through downward to the ground to reach the groundwater or ground level, so that water should be clear through while passing through the filter. Okay, so we'll go to directly here. This is because we have to do the estimation of this. For that purpose, I just give information to you. How the function, but this function is already we have discussed in environmental engineering, that is also called wastewater supply engineering. Okay, so now we'll go to another problem. So that is the problem number first one. The problem, as per a problem number, you can see it here. The problem number in their first particular is earthwork excavation of hard soil. Correct, there are two pits are there, one is called soak septic tank, another one is called soak pit. Here First we'll go to septic tank. Septic tank, we'll go to septic tank. Here the septic tank length is equal to, what is the length of the septic tank? You can see it here. Total length of the septic tank including external wall. See here, this plan is nothing but wall of 8.6. This is the wall of this top view. This is the plan which is showing only one wall, that is 20 centimeter wall. Right, that is 30 centimeter wall. See, this is 30 centimeter wall and this is inner to inner distance, right? So this is inner to inner distance. He can inner to inner distance. So here the only this up to here the plan is shown up to here. See, this is the plan has shown in this particular figure. So we cannot consider total overall length 7.6. We have to consider this is the total length. Okay. So for earthwork excavation, I'm especially telling for earthwork excavation, right? So we are considering that. Now I'll give a perfect example, that is total length from, because we have to, we are, why we are excavating? First of all, our excavation duty to fill this CC floor. So CC floor length is 8.4. So that much length we have to excavate to fill the first step, it is CC bed to the foundations, right? So 8.4, that is called 8.4 here. So the breadth is nothing but here you can see the breadth, the total breadth is inner to inner is 2 meter, right? Inner to inner is 2 meter, that is inside to inside flooring. So after that 2 meter, so here very important factor, breadth is they are not showing, you have to calculate its breadth as they have given the inner to inner distance is 2 meter. After that plus breadth up to here, so inner to inner distance of the breadth is 2 meter plus the first wall. See this wall you can take, this wall is 50. From inner to here wall this distance is 50, that is 50 centimeter breadth of the wall. You can see the breadth is 50 centimeter wall, the height also 50 centimeter. So 50 plus both the side 50, so both the side 50, you can see it here. So this is 20, both the side 50, so breadth will be up to here 50 wall, right? Both the side it will be there like that. Then and one more CC flooring, 10 will be, bearing is provided here, you can see his here. See, this is 10, again here 10. So total height breadth become 50 plus 50 both the side and 10 plus 10. So total breadth is equal to how much? So 120, that is 2 meter, right? 2 meter means nothing but if you consider it in the centimeter, it is 200 plus 50, 300, 320 will be the breadth, right? So answer will be this is bearing, I just wanted to check here, 8.4 nothing but one, just a clarification here, just to see, I just thought it is 10 but we have to check it properly here. The total length is 8.4, the inner to inner length is 7 meter, that means this inner to inner length is 7. So 7 means this is 7. 7 means this is 8.4, that means this is total 8, then this bearing is 20, both the side bearing will be 20, just to calculate, this is 8.4, this is 7, the remaining here, this is 50, this both the side is 50, so 1 meter gone from the 8.4, then remaining it is 0.4 means 20, that is 0.2 both the side, okay. Here total 0.4, so the 20 you will get it, so that it is 20 plus 20 both the side bearing, so they are not mentioned bearing, you have to calculate, that is 340 will become the total breadth of the foundation. Total breadth of the foundation is 3.40. total height we have to calculate now, so I'll just remove the breadth calculation. I hope you understood this easily. So now we'll go to calculation of the breadth. So calculation of the breadth is the total. We'll go to calculation of the breadth here. Breadth we are already calculated. Height is very simple to calculate, not that much difficult. You can see it here. You can calculate 1.8. That height is equal to 1.08 plus 50. That is 1.08 meter they have given. So you can consider this is 0.5. You can consider in meter. Otherwise we'll go to calculation with the centimeter only. It will be easy to calculate. So that is 108 centimeter plus 50 plus 50 height. You can see in the side they are mentioned in the figure, then 40. So that is equal to how much? The height is the total height, ground level, total height is equal to this 8 cm thick, 0.08 YKM, because 8 cm thick RC slab is included, so that is 1.08. So 108, that is 50-50, 208. 208 means 248 will be the total height of the, 248, we'll check whether it is 248, it's 248, that is 2.48 is the total height of the excavation. So I hope you got it that how to calculate the total excavation quantity. So that for total length plus total breadth as well as total height, if you consider it, that is what your excavation. From once the excavation is over, now we are going to calculate the excavation of septic tank is over. Now we'll go another one is excavation of soak pit. How to calculate soak pit? You can see the plan. It is a circle, right? That means it is a circular section. That is circular soak pit. It is not a rectangular one. Okay. So now how to calculate the soak pit excavation volume of the soak pit? So total height of the soak pit is given. Total height of the soak pit given is nothing but 4.0 meter. That is total height is 4.0 meter. Now your inner to inner distance is 3 meter, but outer to outer distance of the soak pit is 3.6 meter. So how to calculate area? If you want to calculate V, so V volume is equal to pi d square by 4 multiplied by h. If you take, then you will get the volume of the soak pit, right? The volume of the soak pit will look like this, right? The volume of the soak pit will look like this. The top, in the cross section, if you see, it will look like this, and if you see the top wave, it will look like this. So that is what the section looks like this. So calculation of this is nothing but pi d here. D, what is D here? D is nothing but where V is equal to D pi into D. D is nothing but 3.6 meter square divided by 4 into height. Height is equal to 4 meter. So that is what the answer. That is what total volume. Nothing. That's all. No need to calculate length, breadth. This is not a rectangular section, this is a circular section. Just the area you multiply with the height, so that we will get the volume. That is 3.6 into 4 divided by 4, if we get 42.72 cubic meter. That is what total height of, total volume of the soak pit. And total volume of the earthwork excavation volume is nothing but of soak septic tank is 70.82 meter. Clear. So now, only we calculated now earthwork excavation of the hard soil, that is septic tank as well as soak pit. We got it that how to calculate the earthwork excavation. Now just we'll move for the another particular, that where we are going to put the foundation base in CC for septic tank. We are not putting for septic foundation CCs, we are putting for foundation base. We are putting for here, just to see here, foundation base is putting for only CC for the septic tank, because it has a water storing. We are not passing water through the ground level. Here water storing in the septic tank. So that purpose we are putting the CC bed here. The CC bed is consist of height is same as earthwork excavation and breadth is same as earthwork excavation. Only the height is only 40 centimeter. So that is what we are going to change here. That is only height we are going to change here. The 8.4 is length will be same as earthwork excavation because first foundation step will be that only, and breadth is same as that of then depth is only height of the CC floor is 0.4. It is only for suitable for septic tank, not for soak pit. Okay, so that is your septic tank CC bed. The third item, that is, I hope you got it. This is easily. So there is no much confusion here. The third one, first class brick masonry in CM 1:4 for the long wall we are going to take. For the long wall we are going to take CM 1:4. Here there is too much a little difference between the length is. The long wall we are going to take first and short wall we are going to first. As you know that you can see, long wall is look from here and short wall is look from here. The short wall length always will be 2 because all the length will be considered it in the long wall. Other length will be considered it in the long wall. So there is no short wall length because you can, I'll just give the example here for the 30 centimeter wall. If you consider, I'm considering long wall here to here in the long wall consideration, both the number 2, this is number 2, this is number 1, this is number 2. So the remaining will be 2 for all the sectors. So that first we'll consider first base, that is the total length of this, how much? So total length, this is the first base. Just remove the length of 20 either side. So total will be 7, inner to inner is 7 plus 50 both the side. So 50 plus 50, this is 700. In case this is 700, if you take 700 plus 50 plus 50, so that is total length is 800. That is 8. Okay. The immense, if you consider it in meter, it is 8, and breadth of the wall is 50 centimeter. You can see it here, 50 centimeter breadth of the wall, that is 0.5, and height of the wall, you can see it here, 50 centimeter height. So height will be 0.5. The first footing is over, our first step is over. Now we'll be moving for the second step. That is, second step will be consideration of 40 centimeter wall. That's all. We'll go to second wall. That is consideration of second wall. That is inside to inside distance. You can see 7 meter plus. So here also inside to inside distance will be 7 meter plus. Now it is not 50 centimeter wall. Now it is second footing. No, 40 centimeter wall. So both the side it is 40 plus 40. So 70 means 700 plus 40 plus 40 is 80. So 7.8 will be the length. That is 7.8 will be the length. The total length will be 7.8. The total length will be 7.8. What is the breadth of the wall? Actually, we taken 7 plus 0.4, 0.4. The breadth of the wall is 0.4. And height of the wall is, you can see again here, 50 centimeters. So that will be 50 centimeters reflected here. That is depth or height of the wall. The total length, total wall is 2. Total long wall is 2. So there is first step is over, second step is over. Third step is of the long wall is, now we are the inner to inner distance as usual it is 700. So 30 centimeter wall, you can see it here. The breadth is 30 centimeter wall. 30 centimeter wall is nothing but 30 plus 30, 760. That is 7.60. The 30 centimeter wall breadth is total height. You can see it here, 1.08. It is inclusion of RCC slab. So right, it is inclusion of RCC slab that has to be removed. 8 centimeter has to be removed means you have to take 1.08 minus 8 centimeter, 0.08. So that is total length of the wall is 1. You will get it 1. Okay, that is what 1. So that is 1.808 meter is shown here. That 1.08, in that 8 centimeter of the thickness of the slab is included, but because we are not considering slab here, we are considering only wall here, so that it is only 1 meter. Hope so you understood. easily. So now, we'll go for short wall. Short wall, nothing but only we are, see, I already told that 2 meter only the short wall always. So only the length will be going to change with a 2, 2, 2. For first step it is 2, again second step it will be 2 and third step will be 2, because other all the consideration we are taken in the long wall, and remaining length of the breadth will be same as the long wall, as well as depth is same as the long wall. There is no much confusion here, just 2 we are taking, because only we are all other length will be considered it in the long wall. Okay, now we are moving to another detailing. That is another detailing is nothing but that is RCC slab. How to see RCC? See, here we are not consider here in the in, this is first class brick masonry. We are considered for only for septic tank, not for soak pit. Soak pit we are considering separately. Now we are going for RCC slab. Now when you take RCC slab for a septic tank, we here both the septic tank has a RCC slab as well as your soak pit has a RCC slab. So we have to consider it separately because it's a circular section. So now in the septic tank, when you consider it here, the septic tank RCC slab is considered bearing is not half or 10. Here is the bearing is outer to outer bearing, so total 30. So length will be 700 inner to inner distance plus it, the bearing is extended up to outside of the 30 centimeter wall. So the length will be 30 plus 30 on both the sides. So that is equal to 130. Sorry, 830 is the length. 700 plus 760. Total length will be 760. 760. And what is the breadth? Breadth is now. See, the breadth is now, this is 30 centimeter wall, 2 is here, so 30 centimeter wall, your slab will come up to here, outer to outer, so that will be 2 plus 0.4, that is breadth is equal to 200 plus 30 plus 30, both the sides 30 plus 30, that breadth will be 260. Because 2 plus 20 plus 30 centimeter wall, it is extended only up to 30 centimeter wall, so 20 plus 200 plus 30 plus 30, that is 3.4, that is 8.4 is the 7.6 is the length of the 7.6 is the length of the RCC slab, and breadth of the RCC slab is 260, that is 2.6. One more time, I'll just repeat it. So now length is equal to 760, as I mentioned, that is the length is equal to 760 because it is inner to inner length is 700 plus 30 plus 30. Again, breadth is equal to 2 plus here 30, here 30. So that is 2 plus 30 plus 30, that is 200 plus 30 plus 30 is equal to 260. This is breadth of the breadth. So total length is equal to 760 by 260, that is 260. So here we are going to put the slab. So here we are going to that area, we are going to put the slab. So here you can see that is 7.60 and 2.60. Thickness of the slab is 0.08. That you can see 8 centimeter thickness divided by 100. If you do, you will get it in the meter. That is 0.08 in meter cube. You will get it, that if you multiply with the length and breadth, you will get it in 1.8 meter cube. Then when we are considering the soak width, just remember here,
considering in the circuit, it is very simple. First you take the area of the area, that is here also outer to outer they are extended. See, here also outer to outer they are extended. So now we'll take only, you can see this is a slab. See, you can see thickness. This is only the thickness. Slab thickness is only about. Wait, just I'll make a clear figure. But it is very small. See, very small. So this is the thickness of the slab. Think this is the thickness of the slab. Now volume of the slab is equal to pi d square by 4. Pi d square by 4 into h. So pi d. What is diameter of the slab we are going to take? See, it is the slab is extended up to outer to outer. So that is equal to again 3.6 square, because 3.6 here you can see. Into height only you are taking. Now slab is equal to 8 means 0.08, so that is your slab. That is what we are going to consider here. 3.6 square into 0.08, that is equal to 0.81, that is total is equal to 2.39 cubic meter, 3.29 cubic meter.
Okay, so that is what about today's topic.
We'll go to, we have a another particular, so that is plastering. So now we got it, soak pit, how to calculate the RCC slab for the soak pit. Now manhole cover is nothing but they have given the dimension here for the manhole cover or septic tank cover. That is, you can see manhole cover 60 by 50. You can see it here that this is your manhole cover. Highlight, I'll just highlight it. Using highlighter, I am just highlighting here. See, this is manhole cover. How much that is, manhole cover is nothing but for 60 by 40, you can see in the section here, it is for the septic tank manhole cover is 60 by 50 with the thickness of RCC slab. That is here you can see manhole cover is 0.6, 0.3, 50 by 60 into thickness of RCC slab. That is, you can deduct from the slab. You can deduct it from the slab because they are given the mention. See, this much portion will be not covered with RCC slab, right? Because it has covered with a manhole cover. So it has to go inside. There should not be RCC wall. For that purpose, we are deducting that from the total this volume. So that total volume, we are deducting 0.024. So you will get total volume is 2.37 cubic meter. We are getting total 2.37 cubic meter. So I'll erase it. Now another item we are going now. Another item, it is so. Another, we are going to discuss here plastering with the cement with water waterproof compound. That is for the septic tank is different than the deduct of the baffle wall. That we'll see now. That is plastering we are going to take here. Plastering only they have given, the last item is plastering with the CM of 1:4 with the waterproof compound. So plastering we are going to put here only. See, this portion we are going to put plastering on this, and this portion, that is nothing but you can see in the plan here, and here as well as here. So you will get two long walls and two short walls, you will get it. Okay. So how to take the length for the septic tank first? Now we'll take a long wall. We'll take a long wall. First we'll take a consider a long wall. Inner to inner distance is 7. So total height inner to from the height it is total height it is 50 plus 50 plus 1 2. That is two long walls. Inner to inner distance is 7 and 2 is the total. 2 is the total long wall. 2 is the total two is the total height of the wall, and 2 is the 2 number of long wall, and 7 will be the your total length of the wall. Same way, short wall will be always 2, as I mentioned, always 2, because you are already considered it in the long wall. So total remaining it will be 2. So this space is only 2, and height will be as same as your height of the wall, of the inner wall of the septic tank. So that is your 28 meter cube and 8. So side baffled wall you can reduce, because little you can reduce if required, 2 into 0.2. That is, you can see here side baffled wall. So this has to be reduced. See, this portion has to be reduced here. 2 numbers. 2 into, because here wall is there, no? So there is no plastering here. 2 into, what is the thickness of the total height? Height, if you consider, it is 2. And here the thickness is 20 centimeter. That is 0.2 into total 1.5 wall length is there. You can see here only one total one length is 1.5, not up to total height of the septic tank. Only 1.5 meter. So that is only 1.5 meter here, 0.2 here. So two numbers. So that has to be deducted. So that has to be deducted from the total volume. Total volume has to be deducted. So this has to be deducted from the total volume. So total it will get 34.54 meter square meter. 35.40 square meter. This will be the 35.40 square meter. So now this is just once again I'll recall today's topic. Just we will recall today's topic, that is very important. Two parameter we discussed here today, that is one is excavation of the septic tank. Design details are given. Just we are finding the estimation of earthwork excavation as well as foundation with the CC and first class brick masonry, and our portion of the wall we calculated, RCC slab for the particular figure, that is particular design of septic tank, and as well as plastering with a CM 1:4 with a waterproof compound for this particular phases that we discussed. And coming to this very important matter here, we had a two septic tank as well as soak pit. They are not asked the design here to calculate the in particularly soak pit. That is has to be discussed in the next coming module of part, another part of the video. Here we can easily do this calculation of only soak pit. So now we are discussed here septic tank earthwork excavation in the hard soil, that is septic tank as well as soak pit. Soak pit as a circular section, we are taken pi d square by 4 into h, and so septic tank is a rectangular section, that is length into breadth into height. So that is the volume, right? So foundation base, with a foundation base we discussed for only septic tank, and as well as septic tank has, and one more thing, that is brick masonry. Here you can see first step, second step, third step, that is first step, second step, third step, again short wall, and RCC slab for soak pit as well as septic tank, that is we discussed, and we are deducted manhole cover, because there is no slab in the manhole cover, that has to be deduct, so that otherwise is extra burden, this unnecessary volume we are considering. The estimation will be rate will be going to high. The plastering with the same with 1:4 with a waterproof compound, inside wall, septic tank, that is long wall as well as short wall. Okay, so this is about today's topic, that is total 35.4 square meter we are getting. The next coming tomorrow's topic, tomorrow means next module will be going, next part of the video will be going to calculate soakpit as well as soakpit one, only soakpit calculation, how to calculate the soakpit is the different for the different material, that is only for the two materials are provided, how to calculate earthwork excavation for this, and another one is estimation of road work. We are going to calculate estimation of road work, very important topic which we are going to discuss in the next module. Thank you for today's video. Thank you.